good grief. One of these days, I really need to fix that camera. There we go. Got it. Yes. Now, today's childhood memories are all going to require 640 by 480 screen resolutions and 256 colors, which sadly is uncommon on today's computers, but with the computers at the time, it was common to see 640 by 480 resolutions and the like. So, with that said, get your Windows 95 booted up, or your Windows 98 booted up, whichever one you have, and join on a trip with me through childhood memories. Alright, the next two childhood memories I'm about to show you are Tuneland and The Great Word Adventure, both starring Little Hallie. Little Hallie is a characterization that Hallie Mandel came up with his series The Tuneland, The Great Word Adventure, The Great Math Adventure, and, though it's not been found on archive.org yet, The Great Reading Adventure. If anyone finds a copy of Little Hallie's The Great Reading Adventure, please send me the link to it. I would really like to check it out. Anyways, we're going to start with the Little Hallie series, first series of, games. The Little Hallie series actually starts with Tuneland, which is what I'm going to do first. And by the way, if I miss certain songs or certain clickable objects in the Tuneland footage, feel free to tell me about it in the comments. Just give me the name of the song that I missed, or a description of what I could have clicked on, or should have clicked on, rather. And then I'll get back to you on that. Anyways, let's start with Tuneland, the very first of the Little Hallie series of games. Alright. Now, this first childhood memory comes from a special place in the 90s, and from somewhere in my heart as well. So, it is Lil Howie Mandel's Tuneland and The Great Word Adventure. We're going to start off with Tuneland for this video. This is going to be awesome. What the heck? Oh, come on.
Hey, look around. This is Old McDonald's Forest. You're not going to see us here. You can go anywhere in Tuneland from here. All you have to do is find the place you want to go. I'm going to play hide and seek in every place you go.
Okay.
Hi, everybody. My name is Old McDonald. E-I-E-I-O, old MacDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O, and on this farm he had a band. E-I-E-I-O,
house to play. If you want, click on me and I'll take you through the woods. This train's heading to the mountain. Click on me when you're ready. All aboard! It's time to head to the train station. Click on me when you're ready.
I'm so sure. Like, if you click on me, we'll put you down to the valley.
Good morning. Did you have a nice night? I did.
Let's see what's clickable here. Okay. Looks like I found Holly here. He's hiding in the barrel of hay. Okay, let's head into the farmhouse.
I know where there's something really good cooking. When you're ready, click on me, and we'll go in the farmhouse.
Okay.
time to make my getaway. When you're ready, click on me, and I'll take you to the hoedown in the barn.
All right, let's see what we got here.
Don't forget to fetch a pail of water for me.
Okay, Mom. Have you seen Howie?
Why don't you try looking in the barn?
Come on, let's go.
That boy.
The mouse ran up the clock. The clock struck one. The mouse ran down. Hickory dickory dock. Hickory dickory dock. The mouse ran up the clock. The clock struck one. The mouse ran down. Hickory dickory dock. Oh yeah. pretty good banjo playing. I don't think I'm in strength that song again.
See how they run, see how they run. They all ran after the fire guys. They fell out together for everyone. Would you ever see such a running guy? The three blind mice. See how they run. See how they run. They all ran after the fire guys. They fell out together for everyone. Would you ever see such a running guy? The three blind mice.
That was so cool. Okay.
Hot cross buns.
Nice song. I couldn't hear all the words though, but still, pretty good song.
Woo! Time to make my getaway. When you're ready, click on me, and I'll take you to the hoedown in the barn. I think I found out how to skip these replays of the song I've heard before.
I remember when I was a pony. It seems like such a long time ago now.
When the old man
she ain't what she used to be.
The old gray mare, she ain't what she used to be.
Many long years ago.
Thank you.
Oops. Whoa.
Oh,
Let's go to Grandma's house to play. If you want, click on me and I'll take you through the woods. Over the river and through the woods to Grandmother's house we go. The horse and the reins and carrying a sleigh through the wide and drifted snow. Over the river and through the woods to Grandmother's house we go. It stings the tongue and bites the nose. Over the ground we go. Over the river and through the woods to pass by that for day. Spring over the ground like a hunty sun, for this is Thanksgiving Day. Over the river and through the woods, now Grandmother's face has gone. It's time to head to the train station. Click on me when you're ready.
Okay.
Head, shoulder, knees, and toes, knees, and toes. Head, shoulder, knees, and toes, knees, and toes. Eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulder, knees, and toes, knees, and toes. Head, shoulder, knees, and toes, knees, and toes. Head, shoulder, knees, and toes, knees, and toes.
I have nothing hidden up my sleeve. Oops, wrong sleeve. Pick one hand, any hand, out of these two.
Thank you.
Okay. Now we can. Now we found Hallie's hiding place. Oh, there's a Santa Claus right there. Let's go to the. Let's
click on
that.
It's time to head to the train station. Click on me when you're ready. Oh. It's time to head to.
I thought I heard something. Nope.
Here comes Shelby.
she comes. She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. She'll be coming around the mountain. She'll be coming around the mountain. She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. Riding six white horses when she comes. Oh, she'll be riding six white horses when she comes. She'll be riding six white horses. She'll be riding six white horses. She'll be riding six white horses when she comes.
Wow. This animation gives a whole new meaning to Barrel of Monkeys.
Hi, this is Howie Mandel. Is little Howie there?
I ain't seen him.
Well, if you see him, tell him I'm looking for him.
Big Howie's looking.
Nobody home. Go away. Nobody home. Go away.
Of a different color. I'm the horse of a different color.
I'm a horse of a different color. But don't remember.
I'm a horse of a different color.
Why? I'm a horse of a different color.
Will a real horse of a different color please stand up?
Hey. Let's see what colors they are.
Look at the door! Why, here comes Sheldon!
I'm the horse of a different color.
Red.
I'm the horse of a different color.
Purple.
I'm a horse of a different color. What's up, River?
I'm a horse
orange.
Of a different color.
Yellow.
Why? I'm a horse of a different color.
Pink.
Will a real horse of a different color please stand up?
Makes me think the pink should have been added to the rainbow spectrum, shouldn't it?
I'm so sure I can be quicker.
Is that all cook boys?
I know where there's something really good cooking. When you're ready, click on me, and we'll go in the farmhouse.
This is Old McDonald's farm. Nothing smells here. Do you really want to leave Tuneland? If you do, click on the exit sign again. Okay, we're leaving Tuneland. Come back again and play with us real soon.
Was fun. What's the next video? If your copy of Tuneland or The Great Word Adventure ever blue screens on you, something like that, then just press the space bar on your keyboard. Tuneland should continue running even despite that blue screen. Anyway, now that we got all that cleared up, on to the next childhood memory. Here's another childhood memory I had from the 90s. Yep. It's the very Great Word Adventure itself. And let's check it out. Strange enough, the game came with a help file that you could read like a little instruction manual. That's pretty cool, especially back in the day. And with that, let's get started. Here we go.
If you think he's lovely, a wellness lesson for this time of year, I'm going to
steal Howie's house.
I know, but
don't complain.
Just a moment,
little boy.
I don't know what's weirder, the fact that it's displaying winter in the middle of summer, or, oh wait, if you ran the program on Windows 95, it would run the game based off your computer's desktop clock, so, oh hold on. Oh, there we go.
Gee, that's funny. I would have said you were a lot older. And I knew that was a compliment.
Oh, thank you.
Please type your name in the guest book.
Now type in your real name. You know, the one they call you in school. And make sure you spell it right. In time. Is that your real name? I mean, I'm not making fun of it or nothing. It's just, well, would you rather have a really cool name? Like one of these really cool names on this list? I will. Here, let us read them to you. Mr. Announcer, please.
Bubble, Spot, Bigfoot, Grand Poobah, Picture Black, Butterfly, Smarty Pants, Pineapple Princess, Angel, Garfield, Scooter, Homer.
Mr. Announcer, please tell us what to do next.
Please choose your name from this list. Picture Black.
Yeah, that's a cool name. If I wasn't Howie, I'd want to be Picture Brain. If that's really the name you want, then why shouldn't it be? It's a very cool name. Then pick it again, and that's the name we'll call you when you're here at Lou Howie's Funhouse.
Picture Brain.
This is where Stinky is. He's my best friend. Of course, next to you, Picture Brain. He's the nicest, most lovable, sweet, free, bright room little fella you've ever wanted to meet. Hey, Stinky! I'm calling you!
I hear you! Break up!
Be right out, Howie!
Ew.
I don't want to go into the house and wait for y'all by myself. Besides, I don't know how to get in.
Okay, I'll refresh your memory.
Thanks for the reminder.
You know, for a start, he's very aerodynamic. If you have an idea, why don't we go in his house and join up with Stinky? But you gotta figure out how to get in all by yourself.
Okay. There we go.
I thought for a minute there that I was going to have to go back and get you. I didn't mind waiting. Give me time to read this little book. Isn't this a cool place? This is my library. It's got a gazillion books. Oh, except for him. That's the Alphabet. He sucks up knowledge like a vacuum cleaner. Wanna meet him?
Yes.
Hey, Alphabet! Come on down! Somebody wants to meet you. This is Alphabet. Sometimes I call him Alphie, but he's pretty funny.
Hello, it's your brain. It is a great pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Hey, Alphabot, what were you doing up there? Checking for bookworms?
I think you would have the vaguest understanding on your intuition, my pretty friend.
I thought so.
Okay, we're here. Now what? Oh, I've got an idea.
not just any old adventure. It's gotta be a really cool adventure.
Woohoo! The Great Adventure. Let's do it.
Oh, I have the coolest toys. Ready?
Ready.
Let's go!
Alright.
Riding in the Alphabot is like being on the space shuttle. Only it's much slower, not as high. But it's almost the same.
Next stop, the peanut scale.
Alright! Now that's a fun place.
Alright. Turn right. Oh!
Master Howard, we are facing a barrier beyond my capabilities to surmount. May I suggest we solicit some aids?
Uh-oh! I get it! You have to help us solve this problem. It's the only way we can get there. There's no words. You have to pull down the handle, like this, and shuffle the words until they're in the right order. Simple! Well, simple for me, because I can get them once they're in the right order. Click on this button, and we can get out of here.
This is where you have to put the words in alphabetical, or A, B, C, order. For example, in alphabetical order, apple comes before baby.
Okay.
Eyelashes. Coat. Moon.
Nope.
Coat. Moon. Eyelashes. Coat. Eyelashes. Moon.
Yep.
Hey, you did it!
We are online and ready to proceed.
All right. Whoa.
Master Howard, our ubiquitous little friend seems to be perspiring profusely.
Yeah, and Stinky is really sweaty, too. Let's give him a bath.
They'll have to tie me up and drag me if they think I'm taking a bath.
I think we should probably tie him up and drag him, Master.
Great! That sounds like fun!
Shall we clean him now, sir?
Sure. Let's play Wash Stinky. I don't know how much he loves that kind of stuff. Here's how we're gonna do it. I'll think of a secret word, and you have to guess what it is. Yeah, you do that by grinding the letters that make the word one at a time. For every word you guess correctly, Sammy, our peanut loving sword, will lower Stinky closer into the water, and closer, until he gets it back. All you need is five correct words, and sploosh! We got the scout! Or, but if you get some wrong stuff, you'll lose points. That's really nasty, don't you think? And the worst part is that Stinky gets to move away from the box. And we don't want that to happen, do we?
Mm-mm.
Hang on. These guys are serious.
Okay.
I'm thinking of a world that has four letters. Look, this is kind of complicated. That doesn't seem right.
Yes. T. A. E.
Great! Yeah.
M.
Nope, not this time.
I.
The starfish thanks you.
M. L.
I thought that was right.
We can't escape if we do that too often.
D. H. I.
Ooh.
Yay, you did it!
Correct.
It's another world that has four.
T. S. R. N.
Uh-oh, we might escape.
E.
Oops, we're going the wrong way.
A.
Nice try.
Ooh.
O. D.
I would have guessed that letter too.
I didn't already know what that was.
Yeah.
H. You guessed it!
Yeah! Took me a while though. Alright.
It's another world that has four.
Eight.
Our letter was in the other single world.
E.
How did you know that?
I.
You are incredible.
N.
You know Stinky is loving this, don't you?
L.
Lem.
You are really great at this.
Thanks. Okay.
It's another world that has three letters.
E. A.
That's fine.
I. T.
Almost, nearly, so close. Okay.
D.
That doesn't seem right.
E.
Nope. Not this time.
Nope.
N.
Uh-oh. Think he may escape if we do that too often.
Oh.
L. Oil.
Yes, correct, Mundo. You got the word.
Hmm.
world that has...
Boy!
Ski.
Careful. Let us stay.
A.
Okay, there's an A.
E.
Good boy, we're playing Mount the Skunk.
I. O.
Oh, yes!
Welcome, Stinky!
Oh, yeah.
You did great! Okay, time to go. Cut him down, Alfie.
Alright, Tix, stop the ballroom.
Oh,
the ballroom?
Well, that's a fun place.
Okay.
Problem ahead, sir.
Uh-oh! Right, this is like the last one. You have to solve the problem first. Well, you had one, remember?
Great.
Quietly.
Oh. Okay. G. P. P.
Oh, you're sure a good picker.
We are online and ready to proceed.
Oh, this is so great. There are so many of my friends here. Hey, everybody. I want you to meet Pixel Brain.
Hi, Pixel Brain.
Okay, now I'm going to teach you this funhouse dance. I call it the Free Robo Dog who needs to get a hop around dance. But that's silly, because it's called the funhouse dance. Anybody can do it. Okay. Okay, first you put your elbows out like a chicken. Then you put your knees together like this. And then you're squeezing up behind us. Does it just mean, or does this seem silly to be in here dancing with your computer? Okay. Boy, do you look stupid. I'm just joking. Now, start hopping around like this. Put it together with a song. A one and a two and a three. You hit it, the boy.
Oh, you'll see your body and your knees against the wall. You don't mind falling off, so now you'll never fall at all.
Which one of you guys wants to be first?
Don't be afraid to be cool in the shade. Choose me.
All right, next one.
What rhymes with not? did robot, robot.
Oh, what elbow do you part? There your knees against the wall. If you don't have fun at house tonight, you better have fun at all.
What rhymes with playground? Surround, surround.
That's the one.
Oh, what elbow do you part? There your knees against the wall. If you don't have fun at house tonight, you better have fun at all.
What's the ticket? Now let's do another sneezy one, okay?
Pick sneeze.
The time of my karma is now. Who's in me?
Ho ho ho! Give me the chance!
Remember him? A lonely man was he.
What rhymes with he?
Oh!
Company. Company.
That's you!
See, what's the chef? Remember him? A lonely man was he. Scanning around the ballroom, searching for some company. Oh, elbow to your heart, there's your knees against the wall.
We're running out of time, so what?
Rear. Oh, elbow to your heart, there's your knees against the wall. If you don't have fun in house tonight, you better have fun at all.
What rhymes with wheat? Repeat.
Another singing one.
Ah, over here.
Oh, the bodybuilder, he was there, his arms were really long.
What rhymes with what? Matt Duff.
Oh, yeah.
next stop, the cheese game.
The cheese game is Stinky's favorite place.
Obstacle ahead, sir.
Smells like trouble.
Oops, another problem. Over humble,
overdone. Wrong. Carrot. Carrot. Overdone. Wrong.
Count!
Yes! Come on, start.
Engines are now operational. All systems are go.
Okay, turn left. Wow, they crashed right into the sign.
Whoa! Stinky, this place smells worse than you!
This is beautiful. It smells like home.
I've got an idea.
Me dare you.
I'll be adding up your score.
Here we go!
Whack the words that rhyme with spring.
Oops.
Words that rhyme with oat. Quack the words that should be.
Master Hood.
Look out below!
Next stop, the attic.
The attic is Stinky's favorite place.
Problem ahead, sir.
Uh-oh! Same as before. Solve this problem.
Hey, old 11. Twins. Twins. 11. Hey, old. Hey, old 11. Twins. Twins. 11. Hey, old. 11. Hey, old. Twins.
Hey, you did it!
Yep.
We are online and ready to proceed.
Ah!
We're going to the attic. The attic's full of stuff. You never know what we might need or if we'll have enough. Unicycles, dirty socks, caterpillars, coronets. We love it in the attic. We don't think about hygiene. The attic is the one place that we never have to clean.
With stuff. It's got everything anybody could ever want. This is like a dream. Oh, Stinky. I'm here now. What do you want to do? Oh, I know. I know. Looks like Mom has been shopping again. I found our old luggage up there. Hey, Stinky, let's go on a trip.
I ain't going on no trip.
Stinky,
did you say something?
But what if I don't want to go on a trip? I don't travel well. Maybe I should stay here and, like, eat and sleep and stuff.
Eat my lips. You're going on a trip, Stinky. Hey, Pixel Brain, what should Stinky take on his trip? If the one thing from this group that belongs with that group,
and a rotate button.
Sure.
That's the issue.
911, call William Shatner.
What should Stinky take next? If the one thing from this group that belongs with that group on a rotate book.
Sleep, sleep, grasshopper, grasshopper. Panda. Steer, steer.
If we had left without that, I shouldn't do any of the consequences.
I think I blew my pin off.
Now you pop them in the same way that I pop them.
Thanks,
Mom. Way to go!
All right.
Now what should Stinky do? If the one thing from this group that belongs with that group on a road trip.
Gone.
Oh, well, I know. That's what it was talking about.
This house will need a full body massage after this.
Now, you pop them in the same order that I pop them. Way to go! What should Stinky take this time? If the one thing from this group that belongs with that group on a road trip book.
Motorcycle.
Stinky's gonna love that!
Oh, yeah.
Do I look like Arnold Schwarzenegger?
Now, you pop them in the same order that I pop them.
Let's see. Shark. Four. Motorcycle.
Way to go! And what's the next thing on Stinky's list? If the one thing from this group that belongs with that group on a road trip.
Okay.
Allosaurus. Allosaurus. Oh, polar bear. Polar bear.
Yes, of course.
That hurt.
Screaming along, singing on a song.
Now you got them from the singular and the other doctor.
You know, I hate to be the one having all the fun. So why don't we change places and you can have some of this good time?
Don't you think that's that far, Stinky? That's very thoughtful of you. I think a good friend like you deserves a helping hand. Here, let me help you.
Bringing now, Pixel Brain. Let's make it something heavy, okay?
Okay, here we go again. With the one thing from this group that aligns with that group, and it looks like what?
Dragonfly. Dragonfly.
That's too easy.
I should be blindfolded.
Lucky bear.
Okay, here we go again. What's the one thing from this group that aligns with that group and will take part?
Mango.
I'll give you 20 bucks to pick the heavy thing.
Gotta admit, I'm good.
This is not fair.
Now you pack them in the same order that Stinky packed them. Okay, here we go again. What's the one thing from this group that aligns with that group and will take part?
Cracker.
Is it me?
Come on, Stinkmeister, put a little effort into it.
He must be connected.
Now you pack him in the same order that Stinky packed him. Okay, here we go again. What's the one thing from this group that aligns with that group and will take part?
Blueberry.
Pretend it's me standing there.
I love you. Can you say that?
I love Patty. He's not even breaking a sweat.
Now you pack him in the same order that Stinky packed him.
All right.
Okay, here we go again. What's the one thing from this group that aligns with that group and will take part?
Towel.
I'll give you 20 bucks to pick the heavy thing.
Cool.
Talk about horseshoes.
Now you pack them in the same order that Stinky packed them.
Okay. Okay.
Elephant.
Whoa! I know exactly where an elephant is.
Where are you, Phoebe? Where are you, dog? Phoebe, when nature calls, nature calls. Over in the water.
Where the rest of Frassin am I? Oh, Raggin, I'm gonna get that bear. Why that lousy bear? Look at this.
Stinky, not you?
Next stop, the stink gun.
The stink
Yay!
Gun?
The stink gun again!
Obstacle ahead, sir.
Smells like trouble.
Oof, another problem. Over the highway, remember?
Muffle, eyelashes, haircut. Eyelashes, muffle, haircut. Eyelashes, haircut, mud hole.
Oh, you're sure a good picker.
Engines are now operational. All systems are go.
Gonna try and build yourself a friend?
You'll see, Stinky. It's a really cool game.
It is indeed, and I am keeping the score.
This is gonna be great. This is a natural friend anyway. Whoa! That's some pretty powerful ammunition. I hope you aren't loaded for better. The sharpshooter here. Come on, take over.
You may move and fire the steel gun with your mouse. Or, if you prefer, you may move it with the side-to-side arrows on your keyboard, and you may fire it with the up arrow.
Hey, let me give you a hint here. You get something special if you hit the ground. But you gotta be careful, because sometimes he gets mad and zaps you.
It's Howie, you and me against the words.
Shoot the words that are colors. Green. Orange. Gold. Brown.
Nice shooting, little cow person. It's the man who's got the same thing.
Shoot the cinnamon for deal. Exchange, 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 exchange. Exchange, exchange, exchange. Exchange.
Oops.
Excellent shot.
Round three.
Shoot the words that are numbers.
7, 100, 50, 11, 6, 2, 1, 11, 14, shoot the antonym for here. There. There. There.
Next stop, the scary story room.
All right. Now that's a fun place.
I have to agree with Hallie.
Obstacle ahead, sir.
Smells like trouble.
Same as before. Solve this problem. We'll handle it, remember?
Bunch. 40. Clothes. Bunch.
We are online and ready to proceed.
Rush away the cardboard's end, it is to candle light. Tell me the story's end, it's gonna be a fight.
The breeze may make you shiver, so hold on to your bed and beware.
You're gonna be scared,
It's called the bats and rats and ghouls
and noises that go on.
It's called the darkness to the
ear,
and it's also lots of fun.
Look out for a bunch of lizards
and hold on to your kids.
I'd be worried about this place if I weren't so scared. It's like, oh, it's my knees rocking. At a time like this, I remember what President Roosevelt said.
We have nothing to fear but fear itself.
No, I was thinking more along the lines of...
Master Howard, the paranormal activity in this room indicates the presence of a phantasm.
I don't know about that, but I bet there's a ghost in here.
What an astoundingly astute observation.
A phantom in the birdhouse? I don't
know what it's coming. Ghosts. I ain't afraid of no stinking ghosts. I eat ghosts for breakfast. Yeah, sugar-coated ghosts with lots of milk.
Yeah! What? He's thinking. Where are you? Oh no, I think Stinky's disappeared. Stinky, this isn't funny. I know you're here, Stinky, but we still smell you.
That didn't scare me. I wanted to be up here.
Stinky, is that you? Stinky? What are you doing up there?
Me? Oh, I'm just looking for ghosts. You know, they like to hang out in trees. Yeah, they're tree ghosts.
Tree ghosts? How do you know there's not four? Oh. Come on, Stinky. We're on the Great Bird Adventure here, not the Jungle Safari.
So, I'm not
not afraid of ghosts, eh? It's good, because I have a ghostly little tale to tell. When you look at a fright, you can howl at me. But first, you must look for the key words in the log below, and then find the matching words here on my wall. If you can find all those words below, on these bricks, I will tell you my little tale. Just find the letters that form the words, if you dare.
This is pretty hard stuff. You have to be a really good word hunter to get this.
D-A-R-K Dark. S-T-E-E
Step.
B-E A-R
Bear.
T-E-N-T
Tent.
B A C C C B A C K
Back.
W A T E R
Water.
S C A R E Scare.
You've done it. Was the look of the light of Jody gone from the touch you shared with your brother? She didn't really believe what Brad had said about the bears. He was always trying to scare her. Besides, she needed a drink of water. But when she started back in the dark, she heard something strange coming from inside the tent. It didn't sound at all like her mother. It didn't even sound human. With every approaching step, the sound got louder. Slowly, she pulled back the flap of the tent till she could see her sleeping bag moving by itself. Something had crawled inside. A bear. Jody jumped back as Brad appeared out of the dark. That's not our tent, whispered Brad. Don't you recognize Dad snoring?
Whoa! Next.
It's time to play the compound word game. You have been dealt 9 cards. Shuffle them. Try to make the smaller words line up to make one big compound word. Words not lining up? Keep the card again and spin it around.
Donut.
You're absolutely right.
You will win points for every compound word you make. To complete the game, make a compound word everywhere the cards touch. But you must look closely at the game board, because there is also a puzzle to be solved. To get the highest score, you'll have to solve the puzzle and make the compound words. Think very carefully. This is not child's play.
Dish towel.
Covering.
dealt 9 cards. Shuffle them. Now see if you can complete the entire puzzle. Good luck. Myself. Hairbrush.
You're doing very well.
That was great. Let's do it again. Now see if you can complete the entire puzzle. Good luck. Taxicab.
And the applause meter is off the scale. That was pretty good. Better next time. Keep looking.
Sunburn. Wheelchair. Use the shuffle button. Thanks. see what happens. Remember? Now I have two smaller words to make a compound word.
And back, are we?
Obstacle ahead, sir.
Uh-oh! It's problem-solving time again!
Jar. Brick. Barn. Brick. Barn. Jar. Barn. Brick. Jar. Engines are now operational. All systems are go.
Yeah.
Yes, our great word adventure is concluded. All that's left is to check the score. Let's see. I've been computing it as we went along. Ah, here's the ranking.
That's a honey of a score, and I know honey. You have to be pretty smart to get that good of a score.
Congratulations. That is an excellent score. Yes, it is. In fact, I believe you deserve an award.
How come I never get an award?
That's because you are an unaromatic member of the genus Mephitis.
You said you're a skunk.
I knew that.
Let me see. I think I left the award here. I'm sorry. Wrong, Captain.
Oh, I know what it is.
Excuse me.
It's empty. We've been robbed.
Oh, you looking for that trophy? I know where that is. Stay there. I'll get it.
Why, thank you, Arthur Skunk. On behalf of the members of the Great World Academy, I would like to present you with this award for outstanding achievement.
Thank you. Fair point. Let's go on the great bird adventure again.
I would print my certificate.
I'm sorry, but you seem to be unable to print right now. Maybe you should ask somebody.
Unfortunately, I don't have a printer. So, the best print award I'm going to get is a wallpaper. And with that said, this concludes the Great Word Adventure. I may go on it 5 more times, but off camera, I believe. With that said, this is Childhood Memories saying thank you for watching. If you like what you saw, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you soon. You're smart, you're really, really smart. This amazing certificate is now the wallpaper of basically the player of the player's computer. Unfortunately, you can't seem to print it. Thankfully, you can still view it, but it's a wallpaper. And it is pretty good, you know? With that, this has been Childhood Memories. Thank you for watching. So as we close off on another Childhood Memories, we... Okay, what is it? Thank you, dear text. That also reminds me. After the Great Word Adventure, there was also Little Howie's Great Math Adventure and Little Howie's Great Reading Adventure. I didn't know why it said Lujai's Great Word Adventure and it had a 1 on it. I thought that was like the first game where there were more word adventures or something, but no. This is actually the Great Word Adventure was actually the first of 3 games in the Great Adventure series. The second of which is Great Math Adventure. We're going to look into that right now. So let's see, we talked about Tuneland, and we also talked about the Great Word Adventure. But here's one thing I've never noticed before. Tuneland, at least the non-bundled version of it, has a built-in jukebox where you could listen to all the songs in the game. But I never got to see a jukebox mode because, well, my version came bundled with the Great Word Adventure. Here, I'll show you a picture of the CD, what it looked like. Yep, I had a disc exactly like this. Yes, these boxed programs knew how to advertise their features, especially the Saturday morning cartoon feel, if you get what I mean. Back of the box reads, "Fasten your seatbelts for a fun and fast-paced educational ride with Lil Howie and the Great Word Adventure starring Howie Mandel. This unique and unforgettable approach to learning teaches your children valuable language skills they need now." Wow. Anyway, the features are, enjoy hours of fun and learning with 9 interactive educational scenes. Experience more than 100 games, puzzles, riddles, word searches, songs, and scary stories. Smart software adjusts your child's skill level by age and ability. Add words, including this week's spelling list, to its 2,000-word database. Include the free skill-based activity book. Earn reward certificates to use as wallpapers or desktop pictures. More fun than Saturday morning cartoons. Designed and tested by educators, parents, and children, access kid-friendly help from anywhere within the program instantly. That is pretty awesome. No doubt about it. But I'm probably delaying the inevitable. The Great Math Adventure. Well, let's get started then. I may not have any actual memories of Lil Howie's The Great Math Adventure or Lil Howie's Great Reading Adventure, but that doesn't mean that I can't play and experience these titles for the first time. Well, probably not The Great Reading Adventure, but The Great Math Adventure? Definitely. It's on archive.org if you want to download the ROM for it. Anyway, let's get started with Lil Howie's The Great Math Adventure in a section I like to call Bonus Memories. Bonus Memories, The Great Math Adventure. The idea of Bonus Memories is to showcase a software that I've never played before and make new memories with it. Memories that I would have liked to have had in my childhood. Starting with The Great Math Adventure from Lil Howie's Funhouse. Alright. We've done The Great Word Adventure. Now let's get ready for The Great Math Adventure. Are you excited? Because I know I am. Where is it? Not inside this level. No. Ah! Here it is. Kids World.
Hey,
Right. Tuneland house. He's driving me insane. That's all I'm doing. I'm doing everything. 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 I'm doing everything.
Hey there! Welcome to Little Howie's Funhouse! I'm Little Howie! And hey, if you need to have fun with that, you can count on me!
1, 2, 3, 4
Get it?
I get it.
Okay. Before we start having fun, there's one thing you gotta do. You gotta sign your name in our guest book. And another thing you gotta do is you gotta tell us how old you are. That's one thing and one thing. That's two things. Okay, there's two things you gotta do. We're having fun with math already. Use those numbers on your keyboard to type your range here. 0, 1 You enter when you're done, or click on OK.
Please type your age in the guest book.
Okay. Hold on.
How'd you know? That's my favorite age. Great. Why don't you just type in your name? You know, the one you use on your library card. If you make a mistake, you can fix it. I'll wait. Remember to hit enter or click on OK. And you're done.
Please type your name in the guest book. Please choose your name from this list. Picture one.
If that's really the name you want, then why shouldn't it be? It's a very cool name. Then pick it again, and that's the name we'll call you when you're here at Lou Howie's Funhouse.
Picture one.
Okay, good choice. From now on, when you're here at Lou Howie's Funhouse, we'll call you Picture Brain. Sticky! No adventure is complete without Stinky. He's just about the bestest pal in the whole world. What is best to you? Stinky! 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 Come on, play!
Is that you, Howie, old pal? I'll be right out, buddy.
Whoa!
Hi, Howie. I'm ready to have fun. Only hold still. You're making me dizzy.
I'm Stinky, a stick shooter. Stinky, your replacement fella! You're making air pollution!
I always like a little pick-me-up before a big adventure.
Pick you up? Okay, here you go!
Wow. He seems a lot more excited than usual.
Data and testing
Hobart.
You remember Hobart from the Great Word Adventure, don't you?
Yeah.
Pretty much his twin brother. Instead of words, this guy
number. Hello. Any friend of Master Howard is a friend of mine. Exactly the kind of comment I would expect from a repellent skunk.
Repellent? Repellent? Why, I...
What's repellent mean, huh?
Smelly.
Smelly? Well, if you want smelly, I'll give you smelly.
Ho, ho, ho!
What the? All right.
The great math adventure, where I, guide you through a maze of fascinating and stimulating rooms, and you dazzle us with your wit, and I, keep score of the points you earn.
Or not, and you still keep score. Free play is pretty fun.
Or not. Really great to go on the Great Path Adventure. You'll love it.
Or not. You see, you can go straight to any room you want.
Or not. Just hop on board the Great Path Adventure and leave the driving to us.
Or not.
I'm going to say, as you know, that's exactly what I would have chosen.
Your sense of adventure is boundless.
Thanks.
Next stop, ice cream
machine. Ooh, nice.
Great! Sticky will have just you for more!
I love ice cream.
Spooky loves ice cream. This is so great. Okay, you see those blocks of ice? We need them to make ice cream for Stinky. Tell him about it, did you, boss?
Chick and drag a block of ice from the top conveyor belt to its proper position on the lower belt. It's simply a matter of putting numbers in the right order and location.
This is even fun. It's cool and flavorful. Ready to start?
Oops.
Oh no, the motor blew! It's a good thing we have our backup power generator.
Boy, oh boy, was that ice cream good. Yummy, yummy in my big fat tummy.
Thank you. You look like you should use a little exercise. What? Why don't you hop on the boat?
Yeah, maybe you're right. I wouldn't want to lose my stonkish figure. Thanks, Howie.
That's what friends are for, Stinky.
You're overloading my circuits with emotion. Stop before I short out.
You get the right answer. My ice cream machine will feed ice cream to Stinky. Stinky loves ice cream.
Oh, Howie, I'm kind of full.
Oh, you're no fool, Stinky. This game is going to be hand-packed with fun. Just push the red button and we'll get started.
Pick on someone your own size.
Alright.
Select the block of ice from the top conveyor belt that completes the sequence on the lower belt.
That one. Alright. Doing good. Let's see what we got. 138.
You are what you eat, and Stinky's a Sunday.
Alright. There's the right number.
Select the block of ice from the top conveyor belt that belongs between the two numbered blocks of ice on the lower belt.
I bet I know your favorite day of the week, Sneaky. Sunday!
Next stop, catch a batch.
Little bomber, excited. I can't wait.
Wow, who would have thought? Another obstacle.
Which number is in the 10,000s place?
Okay.
There you go. We're on the road to adventure.
Holy cow.
All right, cameras are warming up. Lights are full. Okay, everybody, 10 seconds to the start of the game. Are we ready?
He's got it.
Where's Stinky?
On his way from wardrobe.
Places, everybody. Come on. Stand by.
All right.
2, 1, kill Howard.
Thanks, Sarah Bear.
No problem.
What's better, Stinky? And now, let's give a big funnel's welcome to our player, Pixel Brain. Okay, listen. Behind these powers are mouthful. All you have to do is match the two powers that have the same answer and hit the mouse button with books.
Neat.
The first part is a neat picture you get when you find all the matches. Okay, then. The match begin.
Use your mouse to move around the game board. click the left mouse button to select a tile.
Row 2 plus 6. 98. Are you supposed to type it in? Ouch. Come on, I'm thinking. Oh, I get it. You're supposed to match the tile, I see.
92 plus 6 equals 98.
Now, you're a genius! Or a real good guesser.
Sixty-eight plus 1 equals 69.
That's your match! Another catch! You're sensational!
Oops.
90 plus 0 equals 90.
Right or risky?
Wrong match. Hold on. Oops. Hold on.
8 plus 2 equals 10.
You shall know the numbers on the number one with me.
No.
10 plus 4 equals 14. Nine plus 8 equals 57.
Now you're a genius.
90 plus 4 equals 23.
That's for notch, another catch.
48 plus 3 equals 51.
Ooh. Round 2. Oh, subtraction now. Wrong.
Minus 4 equals 9.
Right or risky?
89 minus 8 equals 81.
You shall know the numbers on the number one with me.
13 8 minus 3 equals 13 5.
You must be using the ESP. Extra smart, weren't you?
Not sure if that's right. 34. Six.
34 minus 8 equals 26.
Man, you're a genius!
Six minus 3 equals 73.
That's for lunch! Another touch!
18 minus 2 equals 78.
Right, Risky!
49 minus 4 equals 45.
You should know your numbers and your number one with me.
70 minus 3 equals 67.
It's a B. It's 2B. Or not 2B, really. I'm very angry B.
Whoa!
Ouch! That's what I call a B time.
Sure ain't to read this rule.
Me, I just hate it. Can I change now?
Certainly. Into a squirrel.
Good night, Stinky.
Good night, Stinky.
Next stop, Soka.
Cool. This is gonna be wet and wild.
Isn't that just like a robot?
Master Howard, another problem seems to have crept up. My engines need to be readjusted before we can continue.
No problem!
I don't believe we're in as tight a pinch as that, sir. Actually, I've managed to derive the equation necessary to restart my engines. But it must be entered by flicking my switches manually.
I think he's talking to you again.
I certainly am.
You are?
First, flick this switch.
Seven.
23 plus 7 equals 13. Thank goodness you didn't hotwire me. You would have crashed my system. At your service, Master Howard.
Thanks. Now, Digibot is going to show us a math problem. Well, it's not really a problem. A rash is a problem. This is just a question. And you're going to have fun with it, because you're really smart. Anyway, the question is going to be right here. And the answer is going to pop up over there. Now, here's where the fun begins. You're going to get to blast the right answer with this water cannon. Pretty cool, huh?
I would say wet. You know, Howie, old buddy, why don't you get out there and hold the cards and let me shoot for a change?
Well, Stinky.
No buts, old buddy, old pal.
Okay, if that's the way you want it, Stinky. Stinky, aim and shoot.
Hold on, Howie. I think we should switch places.
Whatever you say, Stinkston. I just want you to be happy. Fire it will.
All right.
use your mouse to aim, and click the left mouse button to fire.
Two times two. All right. All right. 2 times 3 is 24. Anything times 0 is 0.
What a team, you and me.
All right. Doing good. Again, anything times 0 is 0.
Great shot. You're a natural at this.
6 times 3 is...
That was an easy one.
Six times 7 is... Times 5 is 25.
You're a sharpshooter.
Okay, no problem. Plan that all along.
Times 5 is 30.
Things are really starting to add up. Good job, Pixel Brain. Boy, that game always makes me thirsty. How about you, Stinky?
I feel like something the cat dragged in. Which incidentally actually happened to me once.
I'm afraid I cannot permit Stinky to drip water on my interior.
No problemo. It's time for a skunk makeover. That's a nice look, Stinky.
If you like your skunk puffed and fluffed.
All right.
Next stop, the big time.
It's easy to lose track of time when we play it here.
Whoa.
Wow, who would have thought? Another obstacle.
Which number is in the thousands place?
A 2.
Good going.
Good starting.
Oh, to me? Okay, I can help. What you need to do is put the numbers and the hands back on the clock. No problem for you.
All right.
12. 1. 2. 5.
Yeah, you're pretty smart. Guess that makes you luck wise.
6. 7.
Who turned out all the lights?
8.
say you're rocking around the clock.
9, 10, 11.
One more time.
Minute hand. Hour hand.
Way to go!
Yeah, great. Now, can we see the rest of the place?
Not so fast, my odorifically challenged friend. Master Howard, I am connected and ready to perform a diagnostic test to make sure the clock is keeping time correctly.
Okay. See the time on Digibot's screen? Well, all you gotta do is make the clock meet the same time as Digibot.
When you finish setting the time, click on the button on the podium. 10:06 a.m. 4:58 a.m. 5:49 a.m. 5:55 a.m.
Boy, you certainly can tell time. Congratulations. Hey, Stinky, wanna see something cool?
Sure, Howard.
I love that.
Oh, boy.
Stinky, guess we gotta clean that up.
Yes, Master Howard, I guess we do. Now then, all you have to do is return the days of the week to their proper places on the calendar. Sunday.
Sunday! That's the day I love to go to the beach and get sun.
Monday. Tuesday. Wednesday. Thursday. Friday. Saturday.
You did it! You got all 7 days of the week in the right order. Spooky. Spooky.
Dad! Oh, not again.
My fault.
In this instance, I forgive you.
You help us out. All you need to do is put the months back on the place in the right order.
January. March. April.
Good work.
May. June. July. August.
This could be a career move. Work in the meantime.
September. October. November. December.
12 for 12. I call that a heck of a year.
Click on the date for weeks after September 1st. 1st, 8th, 15th, 22nd.
Oh, too bad. Why don't you call it a day? Any day.
Click on the date for weeks after September 1st, 7th, 14th, 21st, 28th.
Let's try it again.
Click on the date for weeks after September 1st. Eighth, 22nd, 15th, 29th.
As clear as day and night.
Click on the date 3 weeks after June 24th, 23rd, 30th, 30th, July.
Give it another shot.
Click on the date 3 weeks after June 24th. 17th. 17th.
I always get those days confused too.
Click on the date 3 weeks after June 24th. September.
20,
22nd, 15th.
As clear as daylight.
Click on the date for the 4th Saturday in August.
You sure know what's what? I'm rare. Hey, Stinky, you know what Knuckles are good for?
Knuckles?
Oh, I didn't get you laugh.
Enlighten us, Master Han. What are Knuckles good for?
Governing which of the months have 41 days and which ones have 30. Knuckle months have 31. I'll show you. Mr. Han.
January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December.
Yeah, that's great, Lord Howie. But what about February? It's only got 28 days.
And sometimes 29, but only a leap year.
I know why. But why is a leap year only once every 4 years?
Allow me to explain. There are 365 days in a year, correct?
Yeah. Better check your second words. That was a pretty easy question.
But it actually takes the Earth 365 and one quarter days to go around the sun once to make 1 year. Every 4 years, we add another day to February to keep the calendar on time with the motion of the Earth around the sun.
Oh. Hey, let's try that knuckle thing again. Help me out.
Okay. February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December.
Want to try it again? Click on me, I want you to do it again. I could do this all day.
February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December.
Oh, yeah. See this button?
Whatever you do, don't touch it.
This one?
Stinky, what did I tell you?
Nothing.
For your information, that button opens a time portal.
And that means what?
Oh, it means that some putrescent rodent could get sucked to a different place in time.
Don't worry. The last thing I would do is...
my best friend. Lost. A distant time. Never to be seen again.
Correction, Master Hulk. I have located Stinky's whereabouts. One moment. Yes. Here he is on my display screen.
Oh, okay. Then what we have to do is match the date and time on the calendar and clock to the place and time on Digibot's screen. It's up to you.
This is the day of William Shakespeare's death. Be or not. This is the year Shakespeare's play Hamlet was first performed. January 14, 17 April 23rd 5:31 AM 12:12 PM
What a rush!
Where do you find the time to travel? Remember, don't press that button.
My fault this time.
On this date, the Wright brothers flew the first airplane. September, December, 17th, 9:12 PM 7:19 p.m.
It's in it! Stinky's on his way back to water time!
Boy, time sure flies when you're lost in it.
About time you got back. I wonder what happens if you click right there.
The Declaration of Independence was signed on this day.
All right.
1753 June 1760 1774 7-0
July 4th, 1776 at 4:16 a.m.
It's in it! Stinky's on his way back to water time!
That was great! I can't possibly have any more fun.
Nonsense! There's lots more to do! You got it!
Next stop, Dusteroids.
I always like to tell Stinky, what's mine is yours.
Uh-oh.
Isn't that just like a robot?
Master Howard, another problem seems to have crept up. My engines need to be readjusted before we can continue.
No problem.
I don't think that will do the trick, sir. You see, I have arrived at the proper equation to reset my engines, but it must be entered manually by flicking my switches. Yes, well, perhaps you can help.
Of course.
Flick this switch.
All right. Six is two. We have to use more. Just a second.
Remember, if you need any help, just click on Sarah Bear's locker. She just loves to talk.
Ninjabot, you're falling apart.
It must be all that time spent with you, I'm sure.
Activate the startup sequence displayed on Digibot's screen and we'll be on our way.
Ninjabot, you're falling apart.
It must be all that time spent with you, I'm sure.
Activate the startup sequence displayed on Digibot's screen and we'll be on our way.
Sorry it took so long.
28+8=13, 6. Excellent. Thanks to Pixel Brain, we may now proceed.
Although it took a calculator, I apologize.
Master Howard. We have left Earth's atmosphere and are now in outer space.
Hey, the final frontier.
Time to kick back and relax for a change.
Danger, danger! Space mines, space mines!
Space mines?
No need to panic. We can use the Stinkpod to blast the mines.
That's right. It's up to you, Stinky. You must bravely go where no skunk has gone before.
Must I?
Stinkpod armed and ready. Think of it as your own personal spaceship, Stinky.
You call this a spaceship?
Stinky, this is no time to raise a stink above the stink pod.
Well, that's pretty good. We still see one sentence.
It's about speed up full. You gotta help Stinky cross the space lines.
Destroy the space lines. The number displayed on the stink pod must equal the number on the space bar. If you need to add to the number on the stink pod, shoot the blue asteroids. If you need to subtract from the number on the stink pod, shoot the red asteroids.
And watch out! If the stink pod hits a mine or an asteroid, the stink pod's number goes back to zero.
And Stinky loses consciousness.
Oh, Stinky, you're such a jitter.
Come on, let's start blasting. I feel like a sardine in here.
I dare say you smell like one, too.
All right.
Space mines, the number displayed on the stink pod must equal the number on the space mine. If you need to add to the number on the stink pod, shoot the blue asteroids. If you need to subtract from the number on the stink pod, shoot the red asteroids.
You know, you can actually shoot the asteroids as they go by. Are you ready? You know, you can actually shoot blast rifles as they go by.
Okay.
Construction ahead, Master Howard.
Oh, I'm getting a feeling.
Those kind of feelings you should keep to yourself, Stinky. You know the score. Same as before.
Which number is in the thousands place?
I'd say we've got a ticket to ride.
Ooh, Beatles reference. Nice.
It's more than half finished.
Frank says no thanks to you.
What's that supposed to mean? I can build that wall with my tail tied behind my back. That is if I have help from you, Pixel Brain.
That's the spirit, stinky old pal. go with the controls. I love power tools.
Thanks, Howie, old buddy. And I can do the dirty work.
You're certainly qualified for that.
I have half a mind to pull your plug.
And the other half?
Hey, Black, how about giving us a hand?
I'm afraid I don't have a hand to lend, Master Howie. However, I could display the board dimensions that need to be cut and or glued. A veritable piece of cake. A good point. Frank suggested that I should explain how the fractionizer operates. To select a fraction, click on the arrow buttons. To chop or glue, click on the chop or glue buttons. You may also click and drag the ruler down to the taped area Stinky has laid out. When you have completed your cut, simply click and drag the board into place.
Okay.
Frank says, it's a snap.
Okay, ready when you are.
Thanks. Looks like the wall is finished.
Hey, I didn't sneeze.
What?
Oh! Yep.
The voice said, if you build it, they will come.
Who will come?
I don't know. The voice didn't say.
Closing time.
Wow, was fun!
Stinky, I think you could have a bright career.
Working in construction?
No, working for a wrecking company.
Back to the library. Indeed, sir. You've done quite well.
I didn't think you were that smart. Great job.
With practice, of course, I believe you could be a calculator for the ages. The Pythagoras of the modern era.
And you're pretty darn good at math, too.
You deserve an award or something.
Hey, great idea, Stinky. Good
luck. Seriously.
Do we have anything in the library to show our appreciation?
I've got just the thing, Master. Eureka!
You got it?
Got it, sir.
Thanks.
And now, your honor, as president and founder of Mayor Halley's Academy, to present you with my award.
Please accept my heartfelt felicitations on your achievement as well.
I'm
proud
to know you.
Hey, you
want to
put out a certificate that says how great you look? Put on the trophy.
You're really smart. Maybe later.
I'm sorry, but you seem to be unable to print right now. Maybe you should ask somebody. If you really want to go back to the front door, click on the stop sign again. I'm sorry, but you seem to be unable to print right now. Maybe you should ask somebody. If you really want to go back to the front door, click on the stop sign again. If you really want to leave Little Howie's Funhouse, click on
And that's it, folks. This has been Little Howie's Great Math Adventure, and this is the Child and Inmates. Thank you for watching, and I will see you later. Peace out, everyone. I bet you're all wondering why I didn't know that you could get on my wallpaper. The one for the Great Math Adventure. Well, because I was possibly too distracted by the song. And clicking on the trophy automatically assumes you're going to print it. And unfortunately, since I don't have a printer installed in this virtual machine, I can't print. Well, if I had a printer, I could print it. And if I had a scanner attached to the printer, I'd be able to scan it for you guys and show you. But I can't, so I won't. Anyhow, thank you for watching. This has been Childhood Memories. This is the Gamer Nerd, and I will see you next time. Bye, everyone. What, were you expecting another Easter egg? I'm sorry, but the video's over. Go, you're ruining the next video.